Hello and welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for returning. I'm going to be speaking with returning guest, Dr. Julie Harper, owner of Dermatology and Skincare Center in Birmingham and a Galderma consultant. She's returning to talk about Galderma and AKLIEF creams, launch of the Me Being Me campaign. Welcome back, Dr. Harper, and thanks for taking the time once again.
Thank you for the invitation.
Well, give our listeners who may not be familiar with you as a contributor a little bit about your background and talk about your Dermatology and Skincare Center there in Birmingham.
Sure. My name again is Dr. Julie Harper. I've been a dermatologist practicing now for 21 years, all of that in Birmingham, Alabama. I spent my first 7 years full-time faculty and really focusing in even then on the areas of acne and rosacea. I'm now in private practice at the Dermatology and Skincare Center of Birmingham, where I practice a wide array of dermatology, everything from general medical skin cancer, rashes, even cosmetic dermatology, but I still have a real heart for treating patients who have acne and rosacea.
Now, is acne something that teenagers get exclusively, or is this something that can affect people no matter what stage of life they're in?
There's really almost no stage of life where you're totally guaranteed not to have acne. It's, of course, pretty rare in our youngest patients, but we're seeing acne now in 8 and 9 year olds. Yes, that adolescent period is probably the time where we see it most commonly and pretty equally between the genders. But in the adult years, we're seeing a lot of acne. And in particular, we see a lot in our adult female patients. That doesn't mean we don't see it in adult men. We certainly can, but it does seem in that age group to be skewed more toward the female patient.
For those who may not be familiar with the inner workings of acne, we've all heard of acne. We've seen the commercials our entire lives. But what is acne and why is it such a severe condition sometimes?
Yeah. Well, acne is what we in medicine would call a multifactorial condition. That means there's lots of different things that work together to cause it. You know, a component of acne is just genetic. If you have parents who had acne, you're more likely to have it. But it's really an inflammatory skin condition. We have inflammation. The lining of the pore is not working just the way it should. We have so often too much sebum or oil on the skin. And there's even a bacteria that's associated with acne, but it's not an infection. This is a bacteria that's on everybody. It's just that people with acne mount too much of an inflammatory response to it. Now, what inflammation can do in the skin, number one, it can cause acne, unsightly acne. And I like to put this into perspective. You said sometimes it can be severe. I want people to realize that you don't have to have a lot of acne for it to be pretty severe. If you think about how much acne it takes on your face to mess up your day a little bit, most of us wouldn't say, oh, it would take 30 or so spots. We'd say it would take one or two spots. But when you talk about the real severity of acne, I think so often we're talking about the fact that this has the potential to leave behind permanent scars. And it can do that physically, where you see physical scars that stay on people for their whole lives. But it can also leave psychosocial scars, meaning that acne can have an impact at any age on things like psychosocial feelings, emotional feelings. This can cause people to withdraw socially. This is linked to things like depression and anxiety. And so there's a real significant burden that goes with this disease. And it's not just a physical burden. It's often also a psychosocial burden.
How has the explosion of telehealth contributed to that emotional impact on some patients? Maybe they're not seeing their dermatologist like they were a year ago. Now they're having to be on screen.
You asked two great questions. So one is, and this is something that Galderma has really focused on, they've actually done a survey to look specifically to see how is acne bothering people now that we're having to interface in this virtual world. Is it something that, is that better for people that have acne, or is it not better? And it's been really interesting. People with acne it provokes anxiety to think that they're going to have to do a face-to-face video chat. We know that when they do that, 86% of them say that they have been distracted by their own acne on a video call. And if you think about what those video chats are, you mentioned telehealth. Well, that's one of them. But how about, let's call it teleschool? This is not just social interactions. This is actually now the way people are getting much of their education. And so if you're distracted by your acne on the call, this can have a real impact on your life. So it's promoting anxiety. People, heck, half the time they don't even want to be on the call. They turn the camera off, which means they may not be as involved with the call, or if they are on the call, they're distracted by it. But the second component of that is telehealth. You know, acne is something that we have been able to treat pretty darn well through this whole pandemic, because it is something that we can manage over a telehealth visit. So, you know, if you're dealing with acne, you haven't been able to get out and go to the doctor, contact your dermatologist and see if they're doing telehealth visits, because we can help you manage your acne even at a time when it may be difficult to come in and be seen face to face.
You mentioned Galderma's focus on acne treatment. Talk about this Me Being Me campaign and AKLIEF cream.
Yes. So I think the Me Being Me campaign is just very pertinent for right now. Again, it's not really new news that acne causes people with acne to suffer psychosocially. We already mentioned that. But going a step further and really delving into how this is impacting people now that we're living in this virtual world. But at the end of the Me Being Me campaign, the goal there is to, yes, look at this, but to also then arm people, give them the information that they need. For example, about AKLIEF, one good resource is AKLIEF.com. But to give people with acne language that they can use so that they can talk to their healthcare provider, so that they can help talk to their dermatologist and get the help that they need. One good piece of information that did come out of the Galderma survey was that now this number appears to be higher than it was before, but two-thirds of people who have acne are now, they say they're more likely to see a dermatologist than they were before they were doing video calls. So let's give them the information they need. Let's give them the resources they need so that they can get to the dermatologist and get the prescriptions that they need. And one of those may end up being AKLIEF, which is a new topical retinoid.
What makes AKLIEF cream unique among treatments?
Well, AKLIEF cream is definitely unique in the acne world. The topical retinoids have been around since the 1970s. Some of those that you might be familiar with would be Retin-A or tretinoin, adapalene, which is different, to xeratine is another one. But we haven't had a new molecule in that space, meaning a new chemical entity, for over 20 years. And when this one was developed, it was developed very specifically for acne. Our understanding of how these retinoids work has advanced over that amount of time. And so this new AKLIEF trifarotene retinoid is now a more specific or a selective targeter of what's called the retinoic acid receptor. So it just works in a more precise way as we now have a better understanding of what's going on with acne under the skin.
Where can we go online and get some more information about Me Being Me, the campaign, and also about AKLIEF cream?
Well, I think your best resource for those is certainly going to be at AKLIEF.com. And I would direct people who want to have more information about any of that to go to that particular site. You can also always go to AAD.org. That's the American Academy of Dermatology.com if you want more information on acne in general.
Dr. Harper, I appreciate you joining us, coming back and talking with us this morning, and hopefully we'll be speaking again.
Thank you, Neil. I appreciate it.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard, in conversation with returning guest, Dr. Julie Harper, owner of Dermatology and Skin Care Center in Birmingham. Audio copies of this program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, download at SoundCloud, and be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/healthprofessionalradio.